In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet multiplying rational expressions. Our directions are to simplify each expression. And it's important that when we're multiplying those rational expressions, to simplify at the start. And that will just make it easier for us in the end. So number one, if we were to simplify at the start, remember we're multiplying the numerators together and then we're multiplying the denominators together. And remember that this fraction bar represents division. So n will be divided by n to equal 1. So n will cancel out n, so we'll just multiply 59 by 80. And then in the denominator, we'll multiply 99 by 33. 59 times 80 is equal to 4,720. And 99 times 33 is equal to 3,267. And that is our simplest form in number one. 4,720 divided by 3,267. Let's move on to number two. In number two, we have n squared in our numerator, but we do not have an n in our denominator. Also, I cannot simplify 53, 43, 31, or 46, so I'll start by multiplying. 53 times 46 is 2,438, so I'll have 2,438 times n squared in my numerator, and then multiplying my denominator, 43 times 31, that equals 1,333. And I cannot simplify 2,438 or 1,333 any further. So my solution in number two is 2,438 n squared over 1,333. And number three, right away at the start, I'll be able to cancel out an n. I have 93 over 21n times 34n over 51n. So I'll just cancel out these last n's. Since 34n divided by 51n will be 34 over 51, so I will still have n remaining in my denominator. Also note that in number 3, I can simplify my numbers before I multiply them. 93 and 21 are both divisible by 3. So if I write 93 as 3 times 31, and I write 21n as 3 times 7n, notice that my 3's will cancel out, so I'll have 31 over 7n. Now, looking at my second fraction, 34 over 51, both are divisible by 17. 34 equals 2 times 17, and 51 equals 3 times 17. So, you can see that 17 will cancel out with 17. So I have 31 times 2, multiplying my numerators together, that would be 62 over 7n times 3, which 7 times 3 is 21, so that will be 21n. And I cannot simplify any further. Therefore, 62 divided by 21n is my solution in number 3. I also could have just multiplied out before simplifying to get 93 times 34, which equals 3,162 over 21 times 51 times n, which is 1,071n, and then simplified from there, because both of those are divisible by 51. 51 goes into 3,162, 62 times, and 51 goes into 1,071, 21 times. But it's easier to see the factors of smaller numbers than it is to figure out the greatest common factor of those larger numbers. But this does indeed equal 62 over 21n when simplified. Let's continue on to number 4. In number 4, looking at our variables, I have n to the first in my numerator and n squared in my denominator. So that's like n to the first over n squared is equivalent to n to the 1 minus 2, which equals n to the negative 1, which is the same as 1 over n. So we know that our n is going to be remaining in that denominator. Another way you can think of this is that 2 is greater than 1, so I'm going to have 1 n still remaining in my denominator if I was to subtract 2 and 1. So now that we've sorted out our variable, let's look at our numbers. 85 and 25 are both divisible by 5. That's because there's a 5 in that 1's place. 85 is the same as 5 times 17. So I'll have 79 times 5 times 17. And then 25 is 5 times 5. So 79 over 5 times 5 times 27n when multiplying my denominators. Note that the 5s will cancel out, so I'll have 79 times 17, which is 1,343, and that's divided by 5 times 27n, which 5 times 27 is 135, so that's 135n. And I cannot simplify those numbers any further, so 1,343 over 135n is my solution in number 4. And again, that's because I took away a 5 out of my numerator and denominator. In number 5, I only have a variable in my denominator, so I cannot simplify that any further. But note, I'll be able to simplify 25 and 45 because both are divisible by 5. If I divide 25 by 5, I'll have 5. And if I divide 45 by 5, I'll have 9. So 25 45ths simplifies to 5 ninths. Now, looking at my first fraction, remember I still have an n in the denominator because I cannot simplify or cancel that variable out. However, let's see if we can simplify 96 and 38. Now, both 96 and 38 are even numbers, so let's divide each of them by 2. 2 times 48 equals 96, and for 38, 2 times 19 equals 38. So I'll rewrite 96 over 38 as 48 over 19. Now you can start here and multiply your numerators and denominators together. However, I'm going to simplify even further because 48 is divisible by 3 and 9 is divisible by 3. 48 divided by 3 is 16 and 9 divided by 3 is 3. So if I take out a 3 from my numerator and a 3 from my denominators, 48 times 5 will be 16 times 5, and 19n times 9 will be 19n times 3. And that was taking out a 3 from both my numerator and denominator. So now I'll multiply to simplify. 16 times 5 is 80, and 19 times 3 is 57, and that's multiplied to n. So 57n is in my denominator. So 80 over 57n is my solution in number 5. So again, when multiplying rationals, our goal is to simplify as we go along to make it easier. If we multiply at the start, it's a little bit harder to simplify in the end, although it is still possible. Let's continue on to number 6. In number 6, x is my only variable and it's in the numerator, and there's no other x in the denominator, so I know I'm going to have x in my numerator. I know that 48 is divisible by 3 because we just used that in the previous problem. So I'm going to write 84 times 48x as 84 times 3 times 16 times x, or 16x all over 3 times 95. So I wrote 48 as 3 times 16 in order to cancel out that 3. So now I'll just have 84 times 16x, which 84 times 16 is 1,344. And then that's still multiplied by x, and that's all over 95. And 1,344 and 95 do not have any common factors. Therefore, 1,344x over 95 is my solution in number 6. Now, number 7 looks a bit more complicated. However, it's not. Remember, we need to simplify at the start. And if you notice, we have an r plus 2 in the numerator and an r plus 2 in the denominator. So I'll start by canceling those out. Also note that we have a 6 in the numerator and a 6 in the denominator, so we can also cancel those out because r plus 2 divided by r plus 2 is 1 and 6 divided by 6 is also 1. So currently, I have 1 times 4r, which is 4r, and that's all over 20 times 1, which is 20. And I can simplify further because 4 and 20 are both divisible by 4. 4 divided by 4 is 1, so I'll have 1 times r, or r remaining in my numerator, and then 20 divided by 4 is 5. So r over 5 is my solution in number 7. And that's because I simplified at the start to get 4r over 20, and 4r over 20 is the same as 4r over 4 times 5, if we were to write 20 as 4 times 5, and you can see that my 4 will cancel out. And that leaves me with r divided by 5 as my solution in number 7. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Continue on to the next video, where I'll complete the first page of the multiplying rational expressions worksheet.